Okay, so let me rewrite these. Let me rewrite this whole big equation here on the next slide, so that we can have that as a starting point. And you can see again the pattern that develops here. So we have the inflow from one face, from the left-hand side face, minus the outflow on the right-hand side face, times the area of each face. And then similarly in the y direction, we have the inflow from the bottom times the area of that face, minus the outflow from the top times the area of that face, delta x, delta z. And similarly for in the z direction, we have the inflow from the back face, rho w plus partial of rho w with respect to z, times minus delta z over 2 times the area of that face, delta x, delta y, minus the outflow in the front face in the z direction, rho w plus partial of rho w with respect to z times delta z over 2 times the area of that face, delta x, delta y. Okay, now notice a few things here. So when I have all these written out, I can see something. So these terms cancel. So for example, rho u minus rho u, those terms cancel. And similarly for rho v and minus rho v, rho w and minus rho w, those terms cancel. And notice also that these other, the remaining terms, add together. So this partial of rho u with respect to x times minus delta x over 2 minus the same thing, partial of rho u with respect to x times delta x over 2. So I have 1 half of this quantity minus 1 half. So that gives me a whole. Those add up together to give me a whole. And then the delta x factors out. And the same, you can do the same for the second term in each of these other components. And so what happens when I do those in combined terms, right, these add together, so I have a half plus a half of partial of rho u with respect to x times delta x, delta y, delta z. So I have minus partial of rho u with respect to x, minus partial of rho v with respect to y, minus partial of rho w with respect to z, and all of those times delta x, delta y, delta z. So I've just combined these terms in each of these components that come from each of these components of our analysis on this cube. And when I do that, I notice that this delta x, delta y, delta z becomes a common factor. So that cancels out with the volume on the left-hand side of the equation. And so then that simplifies things considerably. So I have the partial of rho with respect to time is equal to minus partial of rho u with respect to x, minus partial of rho v with respect to y, minus partial of rho w with respect to z. And then I can just collect terms on one side of the equation, and all the minuses become plus. So partial of rho with respect to t plus partial of rho u with respect to x plus partial of rho v with respect to y plus partial of rho w with respect to z equals zero. So this this is known as the continuity equation. Or it's a conservation of mass, but it's commonly referred to as the continuity equation in the context of fluid mechanics. And here we've written it in Cartesian coordinates. So this is a partial differential equation that expresses the conservation of mass. Now, we can also look at some other ways to write this. So let me just write, again, the equation here as a starting point. So notice, or recall maybe from previous math courses, that there's an operator called the gradient or the del operator. And so this is a vector quantity, but it's an operator because it's a mathematical operation. So it's represented by this upside down triangle, and I'm showing it here as a vector. So, and this parentheses dot means of something because it's a mathematical operation. So del of something. So del of something means a vector where the x component of the vector is the partial derivative with respect to x of something. The y component is the partial derivative with respect to y of something. And the z component is the partial derivative with respect to z of something. Okay, so it's a mathematical operator that is also a vector quantity. So we can apply this to our situation here. So notice, remember that we wrote the velocity vector in Cartesian coordinates, u, v, and w are the x, y, and z components. So if I take del dot v, right, so I have del dot v, so this is a dot product, So del dot v, so remember the dot product, I take the x component of one times the x component of the other plus y component, product of the two y components plus the product of the two z components. And so what I end up with was the following. I have the x component is the partial with respect to x of u plus the partial with respect to y of v plus the partial with respect to z of w. And so notice again that this is a scalar quantity because it's a we've taken the dot product. So let's compare. Like this looks kind of like what we have up here. Actually, if you compare these terms, they look similar to the second, third, and fourth terms of this equation, the continuity equation. And so actually then I can write, by analogy, I can write the continuity equation as follows. I can have the partial of rho with respect to time plus del dot the quantity rho v equals zero. So the shorthand notation that I can use, right? Both of these equations mean exactly the same thing, but I can write it in this form, and it's a little easier to write. But they both have the same meaning because of the del operator. Now I can also look at a couple of special cases. So one case that we encounter a lot in the context of this class is incompressible flow. And so when I say fluid is incompressible, you know, we mean the density of that fluid is constant. And so this generally applies to liquids, especially under most of the conditions that we would be of interest. That we would be interested in this class. Gases are compressible generally, but liquids, at least for our purposes, are generally considered incompressible. And so if density is constant, then notice that the partial derivative of density with respect to time goes to zero, right? Because any derivative of a quantity that's a constant is zero. It doesn't change. So this time derivative goes to zero. And also, we can factor out rho because it's a constant from this equation. So we have rho times del dot v equals zero. And because this equals zero, then this constant divides out. So for incompressible flow, the continuity equation reduces to del dot v equals zero. Another case we can consider is steady state. And so remember, steady state means that things don't change with time. So since there's no time dependence of the process, any quantities that change with time are zero. So the rate of change of density with time is zero at steady state. And so then we can rewrite or simplify the continuity equation to del dot rho v equals zero. So note that this isn't necessarily the same as incompressible because we haven't imposed the condition that rho is constant necessarily. It can be, but in general it doesn't have to be. So this is the general form of the continuity equation, or the general form of the differential continuity equation, which is an expression of the conservation of mass. And we can write in a shorthand using this del or gradient operator. And we can see how this equation is simplified in terms of a couple of cases that we may be of interest to us in the purposes of this course.